Hello, this quick tutorial summarizes the types of connections to choose from when designing a balanced twisted pair network cabling infrastructure. Let's begin with a look at the options for the links between connection points in a termination space, for example, between patch panels and network switches in a telecom room. Connection options for twisted pair copper cabling include modular cords, pigtails, and jumpers. A modular cord, commonly referred to as a patch cord, is a fixed-length assembly consisting of cord cable that has modular or RJ45 plugs factory-mounted at both ends. A pigtail is the equivalent of a patch cord that has been cut, and because it has a modular plug at only one end, its length can be shortened if needed by cutting anywhere along its length. And a jumper is simply a length of jacketed or unjacketed twisted pair cable without a modular plug at either end. If the jumper is jacketed, it's referred to as a jumper cable. If there's no jacket, the term jumper wire applies. Let's now take a look at the options for twisted pair connectors. The most common type of twisted pair connector is the modular or RJ45 type, where we punch down the twisted pairs of a cable or pigtail in the back of the connector and insert a modular plug in the front. The term insulation displacement contact, or IDC, is used to describe the punchdown side, where a tool is used to push each of the 8 wires in a 4-pair cable into a V-shaped connection point. As the wire goes in, its insulation is cut or displaced, making a metal-to-metal contact between the copper conductor and the connector. Modular connectors are typically mounted on panels at termination points such as telecom rooms, equipment rooms, and data center computer rooms. A less common type of twisted pair connector is the IDC to IDC type, where we punch down the twisted pairs of a cable or pigtail in the back and also punch down jumper cable or jumper wire in the front. This type of connection is not as widely used as the modular or RJ45 type, mostly due to the slower installation time and the need to always use a tool to punch down jumpers when making changes, instead of simply pulling out and inserting modular plugs. The advantages of this type of connection include the lower cost of jumpers versus patch cords and the ability to cut jumpers to the desired length versus having to manage multiple lengths of patch cords. And the third type of twisted pair connector is the modular or RJ45 coupler, where we insert modular plugs on both sides to make a connection between a factory or field connectorized cable and a patch cord. Factory connectorized cables are assembled to a customer's ordered length by the manufacturer and are commonly used in data center computer rooms where distances between equipment cabinets can be accurately measured. A field connectorized cable is assembled on-site by installing a modular plug manufactured for this purpose directly onto the end of a twisted pair cable. Examples include cables connected to surveillance cameras or wireless access points. We'll finish things off with a look at the mounting options for connectors at termination points. Connectors of all types can be rack-mounted or wall-mounted in telecom rooms, equipment rooms, or data center computer rooms. Rack-mounting patch panels with modular cords is a common practice, but wall mounting with jumpers or patch cords can also be considered if space is at a premium or costs need to be minimized. That's it. We're done. Thanks for watching.